Hey guys, we are back for day 11 of my Thanksgiving Nightmare series. I've really enjoyed doing this, and today I have a film to review that I've seen multiple times, and I absolutely love it, and that is Blood Rage, which this is an actual Thanksgiving movie. So some of the films, like yesterday I reviewed Poltergeist and things like that, some of the films aren't always Thanksgiving films, but I just feel like they're films that are great to watch this time of year. But this one takes place on Thanksgiving, and there's Thanksgiving dinner. They talk about Thanksgiving and all those things. And as you can see there on the tagline, it says this Thanksgiving, it says it's not cranberry sauce, which you hear that line several times in the film, and it's hilarious. And this is just a great slasher. I mean, I feel like it's maybe even an underrated slasher. I'm sure people like me who are horror film fans appreciate it and all of that, but it definitely got the treatment it deserved on Arrow, that Arrow released here. And you can see there that cover, it slipcover is amazing. There's the back, shows you all the special features on that. There's three different cuts of the film. There's like an original cut, which was the video release, and then there's a cut with added footage, and there's also a cut where they kind of blend the two together and kind of make a new cut out of that. I still prefer, I guess, the home video release of it, but they're all good and interesting to watch and all that stuff. But just to show off this release real quick, if you haven't seen it, the slipcover comes off, and Arrow, as awesome as they are always, have that reversible artwork with the killer there, and there's the back of it. And it comes with three discs, and it's got this really nice booklet here, so you can see the discs there with the different cuts and things like that. It's got Blu-ray and the DVD, which I love that artwork as well right there. So I kind of wish they would have done that artwork here. I think that would have been really cool for the alternate cover. But this movie I like the plot of it. You know, there's these two brothers, and it starts off when they're young. They're kids, and their mom is on a date, and they've taken the kids with them. They're asleep in the back of the car, and they're at a drive-in movie, and her, you know, date is trying to make out with her or whatever, and she's like, oh, the kids, and oh, they're asleep. Well, the kids see what's going on. They're not asleep, and they sneak out, and one of the brothers ends up murdering someone with a hatchet, like, at the drive-in. It's awesome. Awesome practical effects in this movie as well. And so they go looking for him. They find him. Well, after the brother murders, he has a twin brother that's there with him. He hands him the axe and basically frames him for the murder. This kid's in shock, doesn't say anything, so he ends up in a mental institution. And then we flash forward to present day, where this brother's being visited by his mom, the one who's in the mental institution. The other one is still out, who is the killer, and all that good stuff. Well, it's Thanksgiving Day, and the brother escapes the mental institution and goes home, and there is the actual killer, who proceeds to kind of go on a killing spree once again, which is the brother that you think is the innocent one, but he's actually the killer. And I'm not spoiling anything, because this establishes this like first of the film. So, but then the brother who escapes the mental institution, Todd, is trying to obviously stop his brother from doing this, who everybody assumes is the good guy. So he goes around killing people in some great ways. Awesome gore, awesome practical effects. I mean, there's so many cool scenes in this that I love, and I would watch this movie over and over again. So one of my favorite kills probably would have to be the one where she's like, oh, where'd he go, or whatever. She looks out the door, and like, she sees him outside, and when she opens the door, it's just his head, the guy's head, wrapped in like an extension cord hanging down. Really awesome stuff. But there's so many good ones, so many good practical effects and things like that. So if you haven't seen Blood Rage, it is a must if you're a horror fan. It's a great film. Definitely pick up this Arrow release, because they give it an amazing treatment. It looks great on Blu-ray. It's just got that 80s slasher film. This was made in 87, and I can't say enough good things, especially this time of year. You have to watch this one at Thanksgiving. It is a perfect Thanksgiving like horror film. There's not very many of them out there, but great slasher, great horror film, and it should be up there to me on par with things like The Burning and Friday the 13th, all those, like, because it's that good of a slasher. So definitely check out Blood Rage. I loved it, and remember, it's not cranberry sauce. I'll catch you guys tomorrow, and for our next review, and we'll finish this up over those Thanksgiving Day, which is tomorrow, and then the next day, Black Friday, if you do that. I don't do Black Friday. It stresses me out. So anyway, but I will talk to you guys later. I hope you have a great Thanksgiving tomorrow, and I will see you guys tomorrow for day 12 of our Thanksgiving Nightmare Reviews.